Hey folks, welcome to Digimento Education. Welcome to yet another interesting video on video lecture on Engineering Mathematics. This is Engineering Mathematics Lecture 4. I am a course instructor, Utkarsh Upadhyay. Hopefully you all are doing great and continuously revising the concepts that I covered in the last three lectures. The concepts that I covered in the last three lectures are very, very important. If you are very serious about GATE and IES and other PSU examinations, this linear algebra chapter from mathematics is the most important chapter, I must say. Okay, if you are well versed with the concepts, there will not be any question left in the examination untouched by you. Okay, let's begin this lecture. If you really like the video, please hit the like button, share and subscribe to our channel and write down your comments below in the comment section. If you face any confusion or doubt by going through the last three lectures, please write them down in the comment section below or mail to us. We will surely get back to you with the solutions, or if needed, we can make a separate video on that. In the last lecture, I basically completed the discussion on some important properties related to the matrices like rank, nullity, adjoint, inverse, etc., etc., which are very, very important. Now, in this lecture, I am stepping a bit further. We are going to study about the system of linear equations. Okay? So, we are going to study about the system of linear equations. So there are basically two types of system of linear equations. First one is the non-homogeneous system of linear equations. The second one is homogeneous system of linear equations. So we are starting off with the system of non-homogeneous system of equations. Okay? A system of equations is of the form, for example, you have a1x plus b1y plus c1z is equal to d1, a2x plus b2y plus c2z d2, a3x plus b3y plus 33z is equal to d3. That's basically the non-homogeneous system of three linear equations. Why is it said non-homogeneous? Because all the three expressions on the left side are equal to some constant d1, d2 and d3 respectively. That's why they are basically non-homogeneous system of equations in three variables. You can say it's a non-homogeneous system of equations in three variables. Similarly, you can have a non-homogeneous system of equations in n variables. Okay, similarly you can have that. So this system of equations can take the form in AX is equal to B, where A is basically this constant matrix, where A is equal to A1, A2, A3, sorry, it's A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3, okay? X matrix is the variable matrix, which is X, Y, and Z. And B matrix is D1, D2, D3. Okay, this is basically a 3x3 matrix. This is 3x1 and this will be 3x1. So if you just multiply an A and X, the multiplication property should satisfy. There should not be the order mismatch between A and X. So if you multiply A and X, we get 3x3 and 3x1. So we get 3x1 as a resultant matrix. For solving this, you have to basically construct an augmented matrix. So augmented matrix. So augmented matrix takes the form like this. You write the augmented matrix as like this, and this will be equal to A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. You club this matrix with the A matrix, you get D1, D2 and D3. So this augmented matrix will take the form 3 cross 4. Okay. Now you have to apply the elementary row or elementary column operation on this matrix, on this augmented matrix, and reduce it to the echelon form. And when it is reduced to the desired echelon form, if the following augmented matrix follows the following three conditions, then you will be able to determine whether the system of equations has unique solution, infinitely many solution, or no solution. Let's just write down the properties. Okay, so we have three different cases. So let me write in the next page. So properties. These properties have got hell lot of importance. So please keenly watch what I am going to write now. Okay. If rank of A augmented B is equal to rank of A is equal to N, which is equal to number of variables. If rank of A augmented B is equal to rank of A is equal to N, which is the number of variables, then system has unique solutions. The system of equation has unique solutions. If rank of A augmented B is not equal to rank of A, if rank of A augmented B is not equal to rank of A, or you can say more precisely, rank of A augmented B is greater than rank of A. Rank of A augmented B is greater than rank of A, then system has no solution. The system has no solution, or you can say the system is inconsistent. The system of equation has no solution, or the system is inconsistent. The third property, if rank of A augmented B is equal to rank of A is equal to R less than N, then the system has infinitely many solutions. Then system has infinitely many solutions. Or the system is consistent. Okay? Or the system is consistent in N minus R independent variables. Okay, so there will be, if rank of A augmented B is equal to rank of A is equal to R less than N, then there will be N minus R independent variables on which other variables depend. Okay, let me start off with an example so that this will give you a clear picture of what I am just writing here in the form of points that will give you more credibility and clarity free of prejudice. Okay, let me start with an example. Now let's draw our attention to this particular example. For what values of A and B, the system of equations x plus 2y plus 3z is equal to 6, x plus 3y plus 5z is equal to 9, 2x plus 5y plus 9z is equal to B has no solution, unique solution, or infinitely many solution? Let's start it with the forming an augmented matrix. So augmented matrix will look something like this: 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 5, 2, 5, A, and this will be 6, 9, and B. This is going to be the augmented matrix. This is your augmented matrix. Okay, now let's apply the row operation. We are basically applying the row operation so as to reduce it to the final echelon form. Now what can we do to make this row zero complete, this row zero? So we know we can apply R2 minus R1, and sorry, I think this is 1, it's 2, 2, 3, 1, 3, 5. So that was a mistake. Please mark the change. 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 5, and 2, 5, 9. 2, 5, 9. It's basically A. Please make a change here. It's A. Okay. 2, 5, A, 5, AZ. This is A and this is B. Okay. That was a mistake. Please mark the change. This is 2x plus 5y plus AZ is equal to B. So this will be 2, 5, A. And R2 will be equal to R2 minus R1. And R3, we apply R3 minus 2R1. What do we get? We get 1, 2, 3, 6. Now, this will become 0. 3 minus 2 is 1. 5 minus 3 is 2. 9 minus 6. 9 minus 6 is 3. This will be 0. Okay. 5 minus 4 is 1. This is A minus 6. And this is B minus 12. Okay, what else can we apply? How can we make this equal to 0? We can say that if we apply R3 minus R2. Okay, if we apply this, we get 1, 2, 3, 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, A minus 8, B minus 15. Okay. Now, this is the lowest possible, this is the final reduced echelon form. This is the echelon form. Now, the first question says, the system should have no solution. The system should have no solution. For no solution, we know rank of A augmented B should not be equal to rank of A, or more precisely, rank of A augmented B must be greater than rank of A. For it to have no solution, we can say that A minus 8 is equal to 0 and B minus 15 should not be equal to 0. So A for that A must be equal to 8 and B should not be equal to 15. Okay, for no solution. Second case, it should have unique solution. For unique solution, A minus 8, A can, so for unique solution, rank of A augmented B must be equal to rank of A. So for that, we can say that A minus 8 should not be equal to 0, which means that A should not be equal to 8 for it to have unique solution. Okay. And B can take any value. Okay. Understood? Because B can be 15 as well. Okay, now third question says it should have infinitely many solution. For infinitely many solution, rank of A augmented B must be equal to rank of A is equal to R less than N. N in this case is 3. So what can we do it here? A minus H should be equal to 0, B minus 15 is equal to 0. So for that should be equal to 0 and B minus 15 is also should be equal to 0. A will be equal to 8 and B will be equal to 15. In n minus r independent variables. So how many independent variables are there? Independent variables will be n minus r. So in this case, n is 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So there is only one independent variable. So so the solution will look something like this. The rank of the augmented matrix will come out to be equal to 2. 1, 2, 3. And this will be 6. Then we have 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. And then we have 3. And this will be 0, 0, 0, 0. You can see that rank is basically in this case is 2. Here only one variable, let's say Z, will be independent. And other two variables, X and Y, will depend on Z. Let Z is equal to K. Then we can say that X plus 2Y, we can say that, sorry, if we apply, if we open through this, we get y plus 2z is equal to 3, which means that y plus 2k is equal to 3. Y will be equal to 3 minus 2k. Okay, z is equal to k, y is equal to 3 minus 2k. If we open through this, we get x plus 2y plus 3k is equal to 6. X plus 2, y is 3 minus 2k plus 3k is equal to 6. So if we just open this thing up, you can get a y and z in terms of k, which means that y and x depend on z, where z is the independent variable. This is independent variable. Okay, so that's why the system will have infinitely many solutions. Let's have a look at another example. Let's have a look at this particular question. For what values of the constant k the system of equations has, the system of equations is consistent, or it has the consistent solution, basically consider the consistent solution to be as infinitely many solutions. Infinitely many solutions, or at least one solution. Okay, at least one solution. Let's just form the augmented matrix. The first thing first, augmented matrix 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 4, 4, 1, 10, and then we have 1, k, and k square. Let's apply the elementary row operations. Let's apply R2 minus 2R1 and R3 minus 4R1. What do we get? We get 1, 1, 1, 1, 2 minus 2 is 0, 1 minus 2 is minus 1, we get 4 minus 2 is 2, k minus 2, you get k minus 2 here, and here we get 0, minus 3, it is basically 1 minus 4 is minus 3, 10 minus 4 is 6, and here you get k square minus 4. Okay, we can reduce it further by applying R3 minus 2R2. So we get 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, minus 1, 2, k minus 2, 0, 0, 0, k square minus 3k plus 2. For the system now, this is the echelon form. For the system to have infinitely many solutions, this should be equal to 0. For infinitely many solutions, we know that A augmented B must be equal to rank of A, should be equal to R, should be less than 3 in this case. So for that, k square minus 3k plus 2 should be equal to 0. If you solve for this, you get k minus 1 and k minus 2 is equal to 0. So this implies that for k is equal to 1 and 2, the system will have infinitely many solutions, or the solutions will be consistent. Consistent solutions. Okay? Let's have a look at one more example. Here we go. Let's have a look at another example. By solving the system of equations, x plus 2y minus z is equal to 3. 3x minus 4 minus y plus 2z is equal to 1. 2x minus 2y plus 3z is equal to 2. And x minus y plus z is equal to minus 1. The value of x comes out to be. Now, by just having a look at the system of equations, you must be wondering that there are only 3 variables but 4 equations. So it's by inspection from here, we can say that rank of A augmented B is equal to rank of A is equal to 3. Okay, it will have unique solutions. It will have unique solutions because there are more equations as compared to the variables. So of course, we can say that it will have unique solution. Another way, this is just by inspection, another way, just form the augmented matrix. Okay, this should be equal to 1, 2, minus 1, 3, minus 1, 2, 3, minus 2, 3, 1, minus 1, 1, 3, 1, 2, minus 1. Let's just apply the row operations. Let's apply R2 minus 3, R1, R3 minus 2, R1, and R4 minus R1. So here we get 1, 2, minus 1, 3, 0, minus 7, 5, minus 8, 0, minus 4, 5, minus 4, and 0, minus 3, 2, minus 4. Okay? Now, what else can we apply? We can apply R3. We can say, yeah, R3, 7R3, minus 6R2, and R4, 7R4, minus 3R2. If we apply this, we get 1, 2, minus 1, 3, 0, minus 7, 5, minus 8, 0, 0, 5, 20, and 0, 0, minus 1, minus 4. Okay? Now, let's apply R4, 5R4 plus R3. We get 1, 2, minus 1, 3, 0, minus 7, 5, minus 8, 0, 0, 5, 20, 0, 0, 0, 0. So from here we can say that rank of A augmented B is equal to rank of A is equal to 3, which is equal to N, is number of variables. Number of variables. Then of course, this will have unique solutions. Unique solution. From here we can say 5z is equal to 20. We get z is equal to 4. Okay. Then we have minus 7y plus 5z is equal to minus 8. If we plug z is equal to 4 in this equation, we get y as 4. And x plus 2y minus z is equal to 3. If we basically plug the values of y and z into this equation, we get x as minus 1. The value of x comes out to be minus 1. So answer will be minus 1. Okay? Now let's have a look at one conceptual question. Okay? This question says, A is a 3 cross 4 real matrix and Ax is equal to B is an inconsistent system of equations. Okay? Inconsistent meaning it has no solution. It does not have any solution. The highest possible rank of A is what? Now we know that A is basically has the order 3 cross 4. If you just form an augmented matrix, it will be of the order 3 cross 5. Okay. Now for the system, if we just try to reduce the A augmented B matrix into its echelon form, this corresponding echelon form, and if we are asked to find out the maximum possible rank of A for which the system of equations is inconsistent. Now, if rank of A, if we just take rank of A as 3, then rank of A augmented B will also be equal to 3, which means that system of equations will come out to be consistent. Okay, if rank of A comes out to be equal to 3 and rank of A augmented B will also be equal to 3, it's quite tacit. Rank of A augmented B will also be equal to 3. Either the last element is 0 or non-zero. Rank of A augmented B will remain equal to 3. So, the system will become consistent. That's something that we do not want. 4 is out of possibility because you just have a total number of rows equal to 3. So you cannot have a rank greater than 3. So rank of A can never be equal to 4. And 1 is also out of, let's try to see between 1 and 2, which one is correct. If we just take rank of A is equal to 2, and rank of A, this is a possibility that rank of A augmented B is equal to 3, then we can possibly have an inconsistent system. Inconsistent system. 1 is also in the case, but we are asked to find out the highest possible rank of A and B. So rank of A will be equal to 2. Okay? And we know that rank of A will be less than or equal to minimum of 3, 4. So rank of A cannot be equal to 3. So that's why rank of A is equal to 2. For rank of A is equal to 2, we will have the inconsistent system. So answer will be equal to 2. Okay? Now let's have a look at this particular question. For the set of equations x1 plus 2x2 plus x3 plus 4x4 is equal to 2, 3x1 plus 6x2 plus 3x3 plus 12x4 is equal to 6. Which of the following statements is true? Only trivial solutions x1 is equal to x2 is equal to x3 is equal to x4 is equal to 0 exists. There are no solutions. A unique non-trivial solution exists. Multiple non-trivial solution exist. Now from here you can easily see that there are number of number of variables is basically greater than the order of the A matrix. So it's quite by inspection we can say it is going to have infinitely many solutions. Okay, let's just form the augmented bit to make it more concrete. Let's just basically form the augmented matrix 1, 2, 1, 4, 2. Then we have 3, 6, 3, 12, 6. Okay, if we apply the operation R2 minus 3R1, so we get 1, 2, 1, 4, 2. This will be 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0. So from here you can see that rank of A augmented B is equal to rank of A is equal to 1, which is less than 3. So it's quite, which is less than 4 basically. Number of variables is 4. So hence we can say the system of equations is inconsistent. This is inconsistent system of equations. Okay, this will have inconsistent system of equations. So it can have multiple solutions, multiple non-trivial solutions do exist in this case. So we can say that multiple non-trivial solutions exist in n minus r. So non-solution exist in 4 minus 1 is equal to 3 independent variables. Okay. So multiple non-trivial solutions exist in three independent variables. So D is the answer for that. This was basically a 2 marks question asked in the Electrical Engineering GATE paper 2010. Okay. Now let's basically study about the homogeneous system of equations. Homogeneous system of equations, of course, the expression on the left hand side of the equality is equal to zero. So let's write down the heading. Homogeneous system of equations. Okay, so homogeneous system of equations is of the form, let me write the equations, is of the form a1x plus b1y plus c1z is equal to 0. A2x plus B2y plus C2z is equal to 0. A3x plus B3y plus C3z is equal to 0. That's basically a homogeneous set of equations in three variables. So that's basically a linear homogeneous system of equations. Equations in three variables. Okay, so this is of the form AX is equal to 0, where A is basically your A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3, and X is basically X, Y, Z, and O is basically a null matrix of the order of 3 cross 1. This is also 3 cross 1, this is 3 cross 3. So depending upon these three, we can basically derive the three conditions corresponding to which we can say that the system of equation has unique solution or infinitely many solutions. So there is basically no point of discussing the no solution concept. So, okay. So properties. So we have the following cases. Now, the first case arises if rank of, so there is no point in discussing the rank of an augmented matrix or forming an augmented matrix, because there is no point in doing that because B matrix is totally zero, so we don't consider that. If rank of A in its echelon form, if rank of A comes out to be equal to n, which is the number of variables, then the system has system has unique solution, or trivial solution, or zero solution. Okay, if rank of A is basically equal to n is number of variables, this system will have unique solution or trivial solution or zero solution. These three terminologies are used interchangeably, so keep those keep all these terminologies in mind. Now if rank of A is equal to r less than n, which is basically your number of variables, then system has infinitely many solutions, infinite solutions, or non-trivial solutions, or non-zero solutions. In n minus r independent variables. Okay. In n minus r independent variables. Let's basically try to understand each of these concepts. Each of these concepts with some examples. Okay. The system of equations x plus y plus z is equal to 0, a plus 1 y plus a plus 1 z is equal to 0, and a square minus 1 z is equal to 0 has non-trivial solutions in two independent variables, then a is what? So let's just have a look at the A matrix. We will have 1 1 1, we have 0 a plus 1 a plus 1, then we have 0 0 a square minus 1. Okay, this is already in the echelon form, and we can see that it has non-trivial solutions. Non-trivial meaning infinitely many solutions. Okay, it has infinitely many solutions in two independent variables, which means that n minus r should be equal to 2, n in this case is 3, minus r is equal to 2, and r will be equal to 1, which means that rank of this matrix must be equal to 1. Is the rank of this matrix must be equal to 1. So what can we, so rank for the rank to be equal to 1, we can say a square minus 1 should be equal to 0, then a will be equal to plus 1 or minus 1. But the second row needs to be equal to 0, so that as a result of which we will have rank of A matrix to be 1. So for that, a plus 1 should be equal to 0 and a plus 1 should be equal to 0, which means that a should be equal to minus 1. So a is equal to plus 1 is neglected, then we will have a is equal to minus 1, we will have both the rows completely 0, and resulting in the rank of the matrix as 1. So a should be equal to minus 1. This is the answer. Okay, let's have a look at another example. Let's have a look at this conceptual question. The system of equations AX is equal to 0, where A is an n cross n matrix, has non-trivial solutions. Non-trivial solutions, it should have infinitely many solutions, and rank of A should be equal to R and should be less than n. The non-trivial solutions for this particular matrix A exist only if rank of A is equal to n. No, this is not the possibility. No, this is not correct. If rank of A is equal to n, then how can you say it will have non-trivial solutions? In that case, rank of A will be equal to n. It will have unique solution. So this option is removed. Determinant of A is not equal to 0. Now what does that mean? Determinant of A is if not equal to 0, then we can say nullity of A is equal to 0. Which implies that there is no row in the reduced echelon form which has become 0 completely. If determinant of A is not equal to 0, then we can say nullity of A is equal to 0. And then rank of A, this implies that rank of A will come out to be equal to n. It will have unique solution, which means that both options A and B are the same. So B option is removed. A is non-singular. Determinant of A is not equal to 0. This is implied what A is non-singular. So all the three options are the same. What are we left with is nullity of A is not equal to 0. Nullity of A is not equal to 0, which means that some row, at least a row in the matrix A, is becoming 0 completely, which implies that determinant of A will become equal to 0. Then we can say the rank of A will be equal to R, will be less than N. Then it will have non-trivial solutions. Non-trivial solution. So option D will be the correct option. Okay, nullity of A is not equal to 0, determinant of A will be equal to 0, which implies that at least a row is becoming 0 completely. At least a row is becoming 0 completely. Okay, so for this, rank of A will be less than N. Okay, now let's have a look at this particular example. If the following system has non-trivial solutions, Px plus Qy plus Rz is equal to 0, Qx plus Ry plus Pz is equal to 0, Rx plus Py plus Qz is equal to 0, then which of the following options is true? P minus Q plus R is equal to 0, for we have these four options. So it seems to be a bit complicated question, but it's not. You just need to consider that it has non-trivial solutions. Non-trivial solutions, it has infinitely many solutions. Okay? Infinitely many solutions, which means that rank of A should be equal to R less than N, which implies that nullity of A is not equal to 0, but the determinant of A will be equal to 0. These are the three informations that we can basically easily derive from this particular statement, non-trivial solutions. So we have to just use that. Let's just write the A matrix. So we have A matrix as P, Q, R, Q, R, P, and then we have R, P, Q. We have this particular matrix, which is of the form AX is equal to 0. So now we cannot apply the elementary row operations in this case, but otherwise this would basically complicate our calculations. We do not want that. Why don't we use another information that is basically derived from this particular statement? That is, the nullity of A is not equal to 0 and determinant of A is equal to 0. So we can say that determinant of A must be equal to 0. That's something that we can easily derive from this particular statement. So let us write the determinant of this thing, P, Q, R, Q, R, P, R, P, Q. This should be equal to 0. Let's open the determinant. We get P in times QR minus P square minus Q, Q square minus PR plus R PQ minus R square is equal to 0. Okay. Solve for this, you get P cube plus Q cube plus R cube minus 3 PQR is equal to 0. Now, we have to just after this we have to go by the options. Let's have a look at that. If we just take P is equal to Q is equal to R, if we just take P is equal to Q is equal to R, we can get left hand side equal to 0. Okay, so here we can say P is equal to Q is equal to R satisfy above equation. So if we take P is equal to Q is equal to R, this relationship can satisfies the above equation. Okay, no other option satisfies the answer. So from here we can say that C is the option, but let us also prove that P plus Q plus R is equal to 0. Okay, now if we make the above row equal to P plus Q plus R, then if now applying R1 as R1 plus R2 plus R3. So we get the determinant as P plus Q plus R, P plus Q plus R, P plus Q plus R. This will be Q, R, P, R, P, Q. And this determinant will come out to be 0 because P plus Q plus R will be equal to 0. This needs to be equal to 0. Then only we can have a determinant equal to 0. So if P plus Q plus R is equal to 0, then we can say determinant of A is equal to 0. Hence C option satisfies the answer. satisfies the answer. So answer will be C. Understood? Okay, folks, I am stopping this lecture here. So in this lecture, basically I covered the two types of system of equation, linear equations. First one is homogeneous is a non-homogeneous system of linear equations and homogeneous system of linear equations. This lecture is also very, very important because a hell lot of theoretical as well as numerical problems can possibly be asked in GATE, IES or MTech interviews. I'm basically continuously reinforcing you to be well versed with the concepts that I covered in the last three to four lectures, because I'm telling it with my experience at IIT Kanpur. I was basically asked a hell lot of questions from linear algebra. So I'm telling it from my experience at IIT Kanpur. So I'm continuously reinforcing that if you are planning to go into an IIT, you should be well versed with these concepts, because it's very, very clear that the IIT people, IIT professors do ask questions, hell lot of questions from this particular chapter, which is linear algebra. Hence, you should basically learn it, considering it as the most important subject, taking it at the top of your priority list. Okay, thank you very much.